Good afternoon and welcome to the fourth annual Here Indiana Amplifier Awards presented by Pacer Sports and Entertainment. My name is Naomi Horton and I'm the head of Here Indiana, a small nonprofit that gives children the chance to hear and be heard. We create opportunities for deaf and hard of hearing children to learn to listen and speak and achieve their aspirations. Tonight, we have a big goal for you. We're raising $25,000 for general operating support. As you can imagine, given the global pandemic, our operations changed, and on March 23rd, we were forced to close our doors. But amazingly, our staff stepped up, and 95% of our speech and language clients are receiving teletherapy at this time. Given the safety, our audiologist is now seeing only the most urgent needs in the clinic. But we're still there. We're online. We're creating Tip Tuesday videos. We're creating blogs. We're offering as much troubleshooting and support as we can do virtually. We will use your donation during this difficult time to ensure that all Hoosier children have the access to services they desperately need. We would appreciate any and all contributions. Thank you for spending the next 30 minutes with us as we honor the awe-inspiring Tamika Catchings.
No, no. Uh-uh. Yeah, you're right. Yeah, no. Hang on 1 second, okay? Yeah, hang on. Hey, you guys are early for the Amplifier Awards, aren't you? Yeah, no. This start for hang on. Yeah, dude, I gotta go. All right. Yeah, I'll catch up with you. See ya. Bye. Hi, clearly I'm not ready. Give me 1 second. I've always wanted to try this. Just give me a second. It's going to be great. So as I was saying, welcome to the 2000 and it's too much, isn't it? You're right. What about now? No? Seriously? Oh, please. Please, yes! That finger thing doesn't work. Don't try it. As I was saying, welcome to the 2020 Here Indiana Amplifier Awards. My name is Damon Strickland, and I will be the MC for tonight's festivities. Tonight, we're going to be honoring someone who I hope doesn't need a whole lot of introduction, and hopefully raise some money to boot. So with that, let's get to it. When my son was diagnosed with hearing loss at age 3, I was scared. We all were. We didn't have a lot of resources. We didn't know what his life was going to be like or how ours would be. I was very thankful to find Here Indiana when he was in middle school, and you'll hear more from him later. But it was great for him to be around other kids who had his same challenges and to meet the people and to see how Here Indiana benefits families and schools and other practitioners with understanding and with legislative support to know how technology can support our kids and help them with their lives. But you know, tonight's not about me. Tonight's about Tamika. And I know I said no introduction, but just to give you a taste, you know, Tamika is the only WNBA player to serve an entire career of 16 or more seasons with the same franchise, the Indiana Fever. She retired as the number 2 leading scorer and rebounder. But you know, my favorite stat actually is when she was in high school and, she became the only player, male or female, in all of recorded basketball history to score a quintuple double. Now that's pretty cool. But that's legendary court work. If we think about her own life, I think it's equally legendary. She currently is the GM of the Fever. She's an ambassador for both the NBA and WNBA. She's an analyst for ESPN and the SEC, and in 2016, she released her own autobiography, which actually talks in part about how she overcame her own hearing loss. Pretty legendary stuff, and a pretty remarkable woman. Now let's talk about how you can support Here Indiana. This year's auction has moved online, and you can find that link down below in the comments section. Just click that for access to our online auction, as well as to find links to donate to Here Indiana. And speaking of support, here's a message from our title sponsor, Pacers Sports and Entertainment.
Good evening. My name is Rick Fuson, and I'm president and COO of Pacers Sports and Entertainment. And welcome to the 2020 Here Indiana Amplify Awards. A little bit of a different experience than in past years, obviously, but thank you for joining us and for supporting this incredibly important cause. As tonight's title sponsor, we here at Pacers Sports and Entertainment could not be more thrilled at the chance to celebrate both the amazing work of the Here Indiana staff, but as well as one of our own, someone who is so special to us, our friend Tamika Catchings. She's a key member of our PS&E team and a person who fully embodies the power to do good that being a basketball legend affords her. Tamika has used the challenges she has faced in her own life to inspire others, one of the things that has made her near and dear to the hearts of so many Hoosiers. Bringing the WNBA title home to Indiana and being a Hall of Famer doesn't hurt either, does it? But we all know Tamika is about so much more than basketball. She's about causes just like this one and making sure others have every opportunity to succeed. So thank you to all the staff at Here Indiana and to all of you who join us in supporting them in their mission. You are changing lives every day. And a special thank you to Tamika Catchings on behalf of all of us at the Pacers and all of us at the Fever. You are absolutely the best. Thank you, Tamika.
And now for a somewhat different perspective on Here Indiana, I'd like to introduce you to my 19-year-old son, Evan, if I can find him.
Hey, Damon, will you let me know when it's about my turn so I can put on my tux and shave my lockdown beard? Damon? Oh, hi, everyone. My name is Justin Allen, and I'm the chair of the Here Indiana Board of Directors. I want to thank you all for taking the time to be with us this evening. Although we couldn't get together in person, we are so thankful you have joined us virtually for tonight's event. Here Indiana isn't just a physical space, it's a wonderful community of people, from our hardworking staff to our devoted volunteers and donors, and most importantly, the hundreds of families and children we serve. During this time of uncertainty, our organization needs your help more than ever. Our programs and services depend on support from people like you. Whether it be your time, your talents, or your financial resources, I hope that you will consider making a contribution to help Here Indiana continue to serve deaf and hard of Hoosier children throughout the state during this crisis. I promise I won't even be mad if you outbid me on a silent auction item tonight. Get your bids in. Finally, I want to congratulate our Amplifier Award recipient this evening. Tamika, you are a great servant leader in our Indianapolis community, and you're a role model to many, including the children we serve. Thank you for all that you do, and thank you for allowing us to share this special event with you this evening. And now, if he's ready for it, I'll send it back to Damon.
Thanks, Justin. That actually gave me time to find Evan. Evan, please tell us your story.
Hi, my name is Evan. I am 19, and at the age of 3, I had developed hearing loss and had hearing aids for many years. Back in middle school, I decided to go and attend Here Indiana's camp. And then I later went again in high school until I graduated in 2019. But in 2018, I had received a cochlear implant with the help of Here Indiana. And I am now I just finished my first year of college at Rochester Institute of Technology, majoring in mechanical engineering.
That's awesome. How about some other stories?
More milk. Do you want more milk?
More milk.
More milk. Here you go. Good, more milk. Nice, you can pour it.
Monster trucks and monster trucks go backward and they need to get fixed because they were broken. I like those monster trucks were Ray Digger and Dragon blows out fire.
What?
Yeah. And they race.
Oh, they're doing races around the track?
Yeah, and they like go over there and they do this and then they go back on there and one go that way to the another next monster truck goes this way and they went in the garage.
What did you like watching the best? The race, or the tricks, or the backflips?
The backflips.
What happened when they did a backflip?
They got cracked and they got crashed.
Well, they didn't always crash. If they didn't crash, what would happen? Would everyone stand up and cheer?
Yes.
Yeah. Did you stand up and cheer and yell?
Yes.
Hi, I'm Morgan Coleman with the Anthem Foundation. We're a proud sponsor of Here Indiana's Amplifier Awards this year, and a special shout out to our newest Anthem Health Champion, Tamika Catchings. Be safe and be well.
We have exciting news. We just have learned that Anthem is going to match your donations tonight, dollar for dollar, up to $5,000. So please make your gift count double and give now.
Thank you, Anthem, so much. We truly appreciate all that you do for us. As we get closer and closer to the moment you're all waiting for, don't forget, click in the links below to bid on auction items or to donate to Here Indiana. Okay? Like, seriously, right down there. Okay? Got it. Good, thanks. I'd now like to introduce you to Emmy Award-winning broadcaster Patty Spittler. Patty has been in broadcasting for over 4 decades and has been pretty public about her own experience with hearing loss, even having won this very award just a couple years ago. Patty?
Hello, I'm Patty Spittler, host of Great Day TV and Pet Pals TV, and big fan and advocate for Here Indiana for many, many, many years. Recently, I had the opportunity to talk to this year's winner of the Amplifier Award, Tamika Catchings, and here's a bit of that interview. What brings us here again, and my great opportunity to talk to you is you're receiving the Amplifier Award from Here Indiana. And everybody knows about my hearing loss, and you've been very open about your hearing disability as well. Can you tell us a little background about how this started for you and what it means to you?
Yeah, definitely. So I was 3 years old when my mom and dad found out that I was born with a hearing disability. And I'm the baby. My mom and dad have three. So my brother's the oldest, my sister and myself. And really, about a few months before they found out about myself, they had taken my brother to get tested and found out that he was born with a hearing disability. So had him. And then, you know, I would talk about my middle sister, Taja, being like the perfect one because everything about her, she's just perfect. And then me, you know, having the hearing disability and eventually having to wear glasses and contacts and all of that. So literally my whole life, really from that point on, having to just get, you know, having to deal with getting made fun of, having to deal with having a disability and, you know, really early on knowing that I was different.
And you told me once that having a hearing disability made you a better player. Tell me about that a little bit.
Well, I think it's almost like a sixth sense. You know, you start thinking, and I feel for myself, I'm really observant. So I'm constantly looking, even when I'm sitting outside, I'm always looking to my left or right. You know, you kind of see things happen before they actually happen. And so, you know, definitely with that on the court, just having more court awareness, kind of being able to see things happen before they happen. So, I always like to tell people, I'm like, it's kind of like my superpower. You know, even though I can't hear as well, I feel like all my other senses have been heightened.
Yep, I agree. Oh, I agree wholeheartedly. It makes me a better listener, too, because I have to focus on what they're doing. You know, I can't look away. So I agree 100%. Now, the Amplifier Award, I won that a couple of years ago, and now you're being honored with that from here in Indiana. And we thank Naomi Horton for all that she does. Amplifier Award demonstrates and praises you for helping the community and helping kids who have hearing disabilities, and also to inform parents that there are some options out there. How do you feel about winning the Amplifier
Award? I'm so excited, Patty. I am extremely excited. And like you said, Naomi has been a great friend of mine over the past couple of years. But, you know, really when I started getting engaged in hearing Indiana, probably been, I'd say, about 5 or 6 years now that I've been just kind of like, all right, trying to learn more information. And of course, even for myself, getting refitted into hearing aids. And even though I'm not a kid, I'm an adult now, but, you know, just really learning about all the things that they were doing and the camp in particular, and just the young men and women. I wish for myself, like, I had that when I was growing. Like, I had kids that looked like me, that talked like me, that wore hearing aids like me, and being able to have a place where I could feel comfortable. To have somebody that they can look at that looks like them, that has the hearing aids and, you know, and whatever profession it is that they want to be a part of, to have somebody that they could look at and say, you know what, one day I want to be like her. And I just think it's really cool to be able to have that stage and to be able to use that platform the way that God has allowed me to.
Good, good. Well, I'm so elated to know you and to say that I know what you do, and I applaud all of your work. I'm just so proud of you. Your family is wonderful. What you give back is tremendous for all of us. And you make me smile. You make all of us smile. So Tamika Kat, look at that big smile. Congratulations. The Amplifier Award from here in Indiana, you can add that to your wall and all your awards. And it means something to a lot of people.
Okay, wait. Don't forget that link down below in the comments section. Click on that link to donate to Hear Indiana or to bid on maybe some pretty cool auction items. And while we're at it, would also like to introduce Indianapolis Mayor Joe Hogsett. Joe?
Hi, I'm Mayor Joe Hogsett. On behalf of a grateful city, I would like to present the following proclamation. Whereas Tamika Catchings came to Indianapolis through the 2001 WNBA draft. During 15 years with the Indiana Fever, Tamika received countless accolades, concluding with her jersey being retired, as well as Hall of Fame honors. And whereas Tamika excelled beyond league play, representing the United States at the Olympic Games, there she led Team USA to 4 successive gold medals. She also continues her association with Indiana basketball as general manager and vice president of basketball operations for the Indiana Fever. And whereas Tamika sought to extend her impact in the community well beyond basketball, in 2004, Tamika created the Catch the Stars Foundation. Today, this organization has impacted over 15,000 young people. In 2017, she became a local small business owner after acquiring Tease Me Cafe on the near north side, now a neighborhood institution. And whereas Tamika inspires not only through her athleticism, professionalism, and philanthropy, but also by sharing her own journey with hearing loss. For children who are deaf or hard of hearing, Tamika's incredible life and her incredible achievements show what is possible for any child with talent, dedication, and heart, regardless of ability. Now, therefore, I, Indy Mayor Joe, do hereby proudly proclaim June 9, 2020, as Tamika Catchings Day in the city of Indianapolis. And I ask all citizens to join me in this observation. Congratulations, Tamika, and thank you for everything you've done for our city.
Erin was born on March 5th of 1992. She was in the little bed next to me, and I remember feeling really tired and thinking, wow, I'm a mom. How I felt when I learned Erin was deaf and I thought about her future, I thought about things like, maybe we're gonna have to move. She might have to go to a special school. You know, I went back and forth between what I wanted her future to look like and what I thought it might be. I remember looking down on her in the crib, and I remember thinking, I wish it was me. Will she have friends? Will she be invited to sleepovers? Will anyone want to play with a little girl that has hearing aids or cochlear implants? It made me sad.
20% of Hoosier children will fail a hearing screening during their childhood. 20 years ago, 60% of parents chose sign language for their deaf children, while only 40% chose listening and speaking. Today, only 15% choose sign language, while 85% choose listening and speaking. What's changed? Technology. With cochlear implants and high-powered digital devices, deaf children can hear much of what we hear. They can hear the music, the birds, their parents' voices. They can go to school with everyone else, get jobs, open businesses.
And I remember her saying to me that she could hear the rain and that she could hear the birds, because she didn't know that birds made any sound. I knew then that I made the right decision. I also knew that it was the right decision for her. Our whole life as a family does not revolve around the fact that Erin has hearing loss. And I'm glad about that.
My name's Erin Harpster. I'm a fourth year pharmacy student at Purdue University. I definitely think that my cochlear implant was a life changer. I don't know anybody that knows sign language that's in my close group of friends or in my family. I don't know sign language either. I'm going to be able to do anything somebody with normal hearing can do, and I don't really have any limitations right now, and I would want that for anybody else.
Each year, more Indiana children need the kind of help Erin got. But technology comes at a cost, thousands of dollars for hearing aids and cochlear implants. The burden is especially difficult for children from low and middle income families. Here Indiana is working to change that and to raise the dollars needed so that every parent and every child have the choice and the chance to hear.
Untreated hearing loss costs our society $1 million per child. That's a huge burden for our state and a big burden for children and their families.
Please give Indiana parents a choice and help Indiana children hear.
Please help parents like me give their sons and daughters the best possible chance.
With your help, every child with hearing loss can get a great education and go on to serve others.
On behalf of all of us at Hear Indiana, thank you.
On behalf of Indiana parents, thank you.
On behalf of kids like me, kids with a great future, thank you for all that you do.
Wow. We're getting very close to my favorite part of the evening, the award presentation. And of course, tonight we're honoring the awe-inspiring Tamika Catchings. She's a true legend and of course, an amazing advocate for children with hearing loss. She's walked that walk.
Tamika, we're so proud of you and so excited about this honor that you are receiving. We look forward to honoring you next year here at the Women's Basketball Hall of Fame as a Class of 2021 inductee. Congratulations!
Hi, just taking a break from the party and wanted to cheer on our honoree.
Congratulations, Tamika, on winning the Amplifier Award. Your sports career is legendary. You have thrilled the fans, and many young people look up to you because of your sports achievement, but also because of your character and can-do spirit.
And you've been such a role model to children with hearing loss and their families. And that's what Hear Indiana is all about. They do so much good. They sponsor a wonderful summer camp for children. They put on a conference every year where hundreds of teachers and therapists in our state learn the latest techniques for working with kids with hearing loss who go to neighborhood schools. And they administer the HAPPY program, such an important project to fit babies with hearing aids so that from the very beginning their auditory development is on course and they can thrive.
So congratulations to Tamika and Hear Indiana. You're a winning team. Cheers.
Cheers.
Hi, everyone. I'm Kelly DiBenedetto. I'm the recipient of last year's eAmplifier Award. It was a great honor. It is a huge honor for me to pass the torch this year to an amazing woman. She's been an inspiration both on and off the court for many young women, including my daughter. Congratulations, Tamika Catchings.
I am so excited to win this year's Amplifier Award from Hear Indiana. Thank you guys so much for selecting me and wanting to honor me. This is a huge honor. I can't say enough, not just for Hear Indiana, but for the work that you guys do, but in particular, Naomi Horton. Thank you so much for just our relationship and our friendship over the course of the last couple of years. It's been an amazing journey, and I'm honored. I really am. I'm excited and honored, and you know, I think for me, when I look back at just my 3-year-old self from the first time my parents found out that I had a hearing disability to where I am today, I could have never imagined all of the things that have transpired throughout that period of time. But one thing I do know is that because of groups like Hear Indiana and because of all these young boys and girls that get the opportunity to come and be a part of something that's so much bigger than what they're going through in that moment, because of that, they will one day be able to reach their dreams and goals. And I wish for myself that at that age and at a young age that I had kids that I could be around to be able to accept myself for who I am. Really wasn't until later in my life, my freshman year in college, when my head coach at the University of Tennessee, Pat Summitt, sat me down and said, you know what, one day your story will impact thousands, maybe millions of people. And I remember looking at her in that point in time like, yeah, that'll never happen, but okay, Pat. But I got back into wearing my hearing aids. I got back into going to speech therapy and just, you know, got back to accepting myself for who I was. And now let's fast forward to the years that I played in the WNBA and beyond. And I am truly grateful for that conversation I had as a young freshman girl in college and getting back and being able to accept myself. But now I have a platform, and I have the platform to be able to inspire these young boys and girls that are coming up and that one day can look up and say, you know what, one day I want to be like her. And whether it's being a professional athlete, whether it's being a doctor, a teacher, whatever it is that you dream and that you want to be in your life, you can do it. And you look at me and you look at somebody and the platform that I have, this could be you one day. And so the Amplifier Award, I am truly humbled. I'm truly honored. I am so excited to be able to be this year's recipient. And I know that, and I promise you, that with this award that I will continue to give back to kids that are just like me, to adults that are just like me, and wanting to make sure that we impact the world one child at a time. So thank you so much for honoring me. I appreciate it. I am so excited. Naomi, thank you. Hear Indiana, thank you to everybody that was a part of the selection committee. I really, really appreciate it. Thank you so much. Best wishes and God bless.
Congratulations, Tamika. I wish I were there in person to give you a great big hug, but this will have to do. From the entire Hear Indiana family, we are so, so, so proud of your accomplishments, and we're thankful and honored that you're a friend of Hear Indiana.
Hello, I'm Danielle Donahue, Executive Director of the WBCA. Hello to Hear Indiana, and congratulations to Tamika Catchings on your most recent Amplifier Award. Tamika, we're so excited for you, and we love cheering for you. Congrats.
Hi, me again. Just a little reminder, Anthem is matching donations tonight, dollar for dollar, up to $5,000. So that means if you give today, your dollar becomes two, or your 500 becomes 1,000, just doubling your impact. So please give now.
Hi, I'm Katie Smith, a friend, a former Olympic teammate of Tamika's, and also a competitor for many, many years in the WNBA. And congratulations on the Amplifier Award. When Ketch and I played against each other for all those years, she was a fierce competitor and gave it her all every single day. And what's awesome is that she approaches everything she does with that same mentality of giving it all she has to her foundation, to her business, to her friends, to every single person. She gives it her all and she tries to make an impact in people's lives. She is well-deserving, lucky to have her as a friend, and congratulations, Tamika.
Hey, Tamika, this is Lynn Holzman, Vice President of Women's Basketball at the NCAA. On behalf of the women's basketball staff, we just want to say congratulations for getting the Amplifier Award. So here's the team.
Congratulations!
As we wind this evening down, on behalf of Hear Indiana, I wanted to personally say thank you. Thank you to all of you for joining us. Thank you to Pacers Sports and Entertainment for your title sponsorship. And once again, congratulations, Tamika, on the 2020 Hear Indiana Amplifier Award. We're going to leave you with a special Tamika moment, but don't forget, any final bids on auction items, let's get those in. Have a wonderful evening, and thanks again.
And that's Catchings getting her 10th rebound and a double-double right there. Shot clock winding down. They need a shot. Catchings! Count the basket. The determination of Tamika Catchings. She sees two players on her. She splits the defenders. Uses the glass. English finish. It's amazing what a little experience will do for a player that is that talented.
Oh, what a drive and a spin to win by Catchings.
You think her numbers are down?
What a drive by Catchings.
The best all-around player in the history of this league.
Here's the switch. Powell trying to guard Catchings. No chance. And one to the line. As soon as they made the switch, Catchings recognized it, took advantage.
Well, talk about tough individual guards at this size to have that kind of handle, that body control.
That's 21 turnovers now for Indiana, but Catchings redeems it, turns the other way. Against Little, behind the back and puts it in. Are you kidding me?
An effort. A little frustrated that she didn't get the call there, but she stays within the play.
Thomas almost didn't see Catchings. Did not see Catchings and turned it over. And what a spin move and finish from the All-Star. Pivotal play, Chrissy, right there.
Phenomenal move and a phenomenal finish by Tamika Catchings. Catchings. Guarded by Quinn and going right by her and then lefty and in.
Wow. And finished with the left.
She's the best player in the league.
That's beautiful.
That's it.
I love it. It's right there. That's beautiful.
That is unbelievable. Catchings now with a dozen.
Fouls won the tip. Catchings got it to Douglas. She lays it in. What a play by Catchings and a timeout to Chicago. and they may have just made the most important play in this game.
The All-Star against the second-year player. 3 seconds. Catching for the win. Got it! Indiana survives in New York in overtime. A fadeaway buzzer-beating game winner. And the Indiana Fever win it in overtime.
But this is what greatness is all about. And Tamika Catchings with an MVP-type play at the end of this ballgame.